Hey folks, this is Best in Slot and welcome back to Prehistoric Kingdom. Those words still feel a little bit funny to say. I've built a very basic mini park, and in today's video I'm just going to show you all six of the dinosaurs currently in the game, including their alternate skins and indeed their alternate species. We do only have six right now, but this gives you a good overview of what the current dinosaurs are and what we're going to be including in our park builds over the next few weeks. So let's get started. And we're going to kick things off over here with our ornithopods and the Edmontosaurus. Now, Edmontosaurus has three different skins, and all those skins are associated with a different subspecies. I'll show you that in a little bit, but basically if we zoom in over here, we can see we have, say, Edmontosaurus regalis. That's the one with the crest above its head. This is the one you'll recognize more from, say, Jurassic World Evolution. It uses the same one with the little crest. And it's a beautiful little dinosaur. It's a little bit smaller than the other one we're going to look at over there. This is Nilak. And Nilak is having a lovely time. I love these bony ridges across the back and this kind of sort of slight leopard spotted patterning. The Edmontosaurus is definitely one of the further developed dinosaurs in the game. And look at it, isn't it beautiful there as it grazes? Let's tell you what, let's hide that cheeky interface. There you go. Over here on the left, this is Edmontosaurus annectens, which some people might call like a nanototitan, etc. But it's very similar to the Edmontosaurus regalis, except it lacks the crest above the head, as you can see. And it comes with a different skin entirely, much spottier, same basic body shape and stuff, much spottier. And this very slight current of blue, like he's getting an electric shock ranging from the mouth down here, and it kind of just fades out across the body. I think it's pretty clear to tell, looking up close with these dinosaurs, how it's just incredible the texture work is, and the animation work, and the modelling work, and look at him just nomming away, having the time of his life. And we have one more to see, the baby boy of the group, this is Edmontosaurus cookbackensis. Of course, decided to have a little, not a nap, but just a little sit down, just a little chill, you know, just gotta relax a little bit for the video. This is, it actually looks like he's doing a little pose. This is a paint me like one of your French dinosaurs moment. Anyways, cookbackensis. Oh, and there's the nap. Doesn't have the crest above the head. A little bit smaller, as I say, compared to... Doesn't that look beautiful? compared to the other two. And a little bit more sort of tame, I would say, in terms of the coloration. But I really like this kind of ombre effect where it drops down from the dark at the top where there's ridges. Again, we've got the sort of spot of blue there. And it fades down into a lovely creamy coffee color. Fantastic stuff. This park... Ooh, what are you doing over there? That's a little broadcast we just heard from our annectens. Now, it's worth mentioning, this whole park, by the way, this took about 10 minutes, 10, 15 minutes or something. Just whipped it up nice and quickly. You can put together really great stuff super quickly here in Prehistoric Kingdom. Now. Before we move on to the next species, I do want to show you this system in sort of in action, basically. So here in the lab, we have our Edmontosaurus regalis. And as you can see, we have different color schemes up here. We've got graveled. And if I click the second one, vibrant, you'll see changes from Edmontosaurus regalis into Edmontosaurus annectens. And again, over here for Arctic, Edmontosaurus cookbackensis. And you can also get a little sense of the scale as well. The annectens is the biggest of the bunch. The regalis is a little bit smaller. And then the cookbackensis is substantially smaller than that. There will eventually be different skins added. You know, it's not just going to be these three, I'm sure. We'll get more and more skins down the line. And not every dinosaur has this system. Some dinosaurs will only have that singular species, and you'll get a variety of skins for that one species, which is what we'll see in a second, actually. Okay, we're next going to check out our next ornithopod. And, I mean, again, this zoo took me no time to put together, and this right here, with this low fence, the people walking past, the lighting, the texturing, how lush the grass is, this is beautiful, guys. I know I'm gonna, like, fanboy over this game a lot, but this is actually stunning to look at. And it was so simple. Anyways, this is Lambeosaurus, has some of my absolute favourite skins in the entire game. So Lambeosaurus is fairly similar to... Okay, we'll look at this one first. Fairly similar to Edmontosaurus in general body shape. Of course, well... Third time's a charm, baby. Well known for its very unique crest. And it kind of looks like, and we talked about this recently on other videos, like a hatchet buried backwards in the head. If you imagine this is the handle and this is the actual hatchet. This is the, I think this is called like cosmic skin or something. It's absolutely gorgeous. That array of sort of colours of the purples and the blues and the sort of creamy yellows is absolutely stunning. I don't know what else to say. I mean, look at it. Isn't it a stunning looking dinosaur? And then that burst of colour, that sort of sunburst effect up there on the crest as well. That's what I was waiting for. There's one thing these dinosaurs should be good for, and what they actually use this crest for is for making resonance chambers to make those calls spread out even wider across your parks. So here's the other skin. This is one of my favourites in the entire game. Don't know why. It's lovely. It's nice. And, oh, you're inside each other. Well, that's fun. It's fun for the whole family. And then finally, we have this darker, stripier skin over here with this sort of mustard-coloured hatchet. Which, if you're into mustard and archaic weaponry, you know, this is a match made in heaven. I'm sure some of you out there, that's a fetish that you're unsure about. Doesn't this look amazing? I mean... Oh, right, the camera's a little bit nuts sometimes. Okay. I mean... Okay, I'll just sit here staring at my dinosaurs all day if I get the opportunity, so... Hatchet man, I'm going to leave you behind, okay? You, beautiful little boy over here as well. I've got to stop saying the words beautiful little boy. Okay, so we're done with our ornithopods. We're going to move on to our ceratopsids. Over here then, the first of our ceratopsids is Styracosaurus. Throughout the entire park, I've tried to use a variety of fences just so you guys get an idea of, you know, what they might look like in your own parks. And anyways, here's our Styracosaurus. You can see we've got the osteoderms slash slight quilling, spiking, popping up along the back, some of them bigger than the others. We've got obviously that magnificent frill, it's kind of indentations all the way along it, and then lots of osteoderms, lots of bony bits sticking out, that huge front nasal horn, and then these, again, this really prominent horn display popping out from the crest. Beautiful colour scheme there, some nice pale blues. What I really appreciate about all these colour schemes, I'm sure we'll talk about this as we head over to this one, which is my favourite of the Styracos, this lovely sort of woodland green coloration in there, is that this is a colourful dinosaur. You look at this and there are many, many different shades of greens and browns and yellows and blacks and greys and all this. There's many, many different colours in there, but they're done in such a beautiful, tactful way and blended so perfectly with the patterning on the skin. And yes, I'm a massive fanboy, but it's done so beautifully that even these very colourful dinosaurs kind of look real and natural. You know, there's nothing oversaturated, and yet it's bright and it pops, and I've really got to give it up for whoever's doing the skins for the game. I actually don't know off the top of my head who does the work, but now this is a little bit of a problem that the dinosaurs do have occasionally. This is deeper water here. And for some reason, it's only my Styracosauruses who seem to do this, but basically they'll go into the water and they'll stay there forever. The Styracosaurus will never move at this point in time. This is his life now. This is who he is. But it gives us a really good opportunity to get in there and take a look at the skin, which looks really nice from here. And then the reflection of the shadow's a bit odd there, but yeah, I don't know. I really like seeing my dinosaurs from outside as well, you know, from outside the habitat like this. It just makes it feel much more like an actual, a real lived-in park. I mean, that is, again, that's fantastic. Ugh. Ugh. Right, let's move on. Let's move on. So we do have another ceratopsid. We do have four herbivores in our little gang over here. We have Nasuto ceratops. Oh, you are hanging about right next to the fence. I've used the big boy fence over here, as you can see. You are also perfectly poised for viewing because you, He just really wants to get out. You know, the grass is always greener on the other side of the fence, guys. Can I move you? Is that a thing? Should we find out? Stop. Okay, there we go. So, Nasuto ceratops. Lower down, the crest is obviously less over the top compared to, say, the Styracosaurus. And it's nap time. Compared to the Styracosaurus, but has this very bull-esque horn formation at the top of the head. A huge sort of front beak area. Love this. Again, sunburst. It's kind of like an ink drip pattern that you do, you know, where you drop ink onto the canvas and you let it splay out and then you drop it on again and you kind of stagger all these colours on top of each other. Also kind of looks like a fungal head from, say, The Last of Us. A little bit. You see that? It even lines up with the scales. Wait, it actually lines up with the scales. I didn't notice. That's nuts. That's actually nuts. Right, pause. Stay there. Look at this. Look. Look. That's madness. That is actual sheer goddamn madness. Right, okay, let's go check out the other skins. Got one wandering through my little lake over here. You'll notice I've used lots of different foliage as well, all the different types. This one's a little bit more plain, some dashes of purple and sort of pale pinks in there. as well. And there you are, there's number three, bringing in some greens, some pale blues. Less colourful than the Strachosaurus in general, other than this one, which has a very fancy crest, but still a beautiful little dinosaur. Penultimately then, folks, with our large, we'll call them habitat dinosaurs, I guess, we have Tyrannosaurus Rex. It actually comes with four different skins, two of which are unfeathered, like this one over here. Every single dinosaur I look at decides it's time for a nap. So if you want your dinosaurs and your T-Rexes a little bit more Jurassic Parkified, or you're a little bit less convinced by the feathering, I know we go back and forth. Look at the eyes, they're so lifelike. I mean, look at this monster. It's absolutely beautiful. This is from these videos. I will just sit here and stare at my dinosaurs all day. How could you not? Just think of absolute beauty. Anyway, it's really like it's getting some natural colourings in there. Browns and blacks and mustard yellows. Big fan of my mustard yellow today. A little subtle striping. It looks a little bit like a bongo. Moving on, let's try to find some of our others. There's the other. So that's the Tyrannosaurus Rex. This is Tyrannosaurus Rex. These are our two unfeathered versions. This one a little bit, well, very different in terms of coloration, bringing in those greens and sort of swampy woodland colors. Still very, very cool. Gorgeous. Over here, though, this is not a Tyrannosaurus Rex. This is Tyrannosaurus Batar, which is still a little controversial. We go back and forth. But basically, this is a Tarbosaurus. So one of the alternate skins for the T-Rex instead gives you a Tarbosaurus. And really the only difference, I think it might be slightly smaller, I can't quite remember, but the main visual difference you can see, hello buddy, is the Tarbosaurus has a bit of a dewlap underneath its head. You can see this sort of skin flap foldy bit over here. The Tyrannosaurus Rexes don't actually have that. Kind of got a bit of a, you know when you've got like milk and you add the coffee to it, or you've got coffee and you add the milk to it. It's got that kind of vibe to it. All my colour references are food and drink. But you know what I mean, where there's this really deep sort of burnt orange colour sort of descends down into the creaminess. It's a strange sentence, really. Look at that little ear hole. I just wanna point out the ear hole. Look at it. Look how adorable it is. A little hole there. Love a little. No, I'm not saying that. Right. That's the Batar, but we do actually have one more Rex, and there it is. Feathered fiends out there, fans of the feathers, you are not alone. We have another Tyrannosaurus Rex, but this time a feathered variant, and this is my personal favourite of the bunch. I think the feathering is remarkable. I mean, the shader on it, it looks like there's thousands upon thousands of feathers there. It looks really, really fluffy. I'm reminded very much of the little kid from Monsters, Inc. It's so fluffy. It is indeed, kid. It is indeed so fluffy. And it's huge. Look, this is fun. Oh, yes. I love this little burst of sort of... I mean, look at it. I really love this sort of burst of electric blue just beyond the eyes as well. And that's what I mean. The majority of the dinosaurs are quite tame in terms of coloration. It's a perfectly interesting, nice-looking dinosaur. Oh, it's fuming as well. And then you get this little burst of color that gives it a little intrigue, makes it look a little bit more exciting, but also still remains natural and what you'd very much expect to see out there in the wild back in the day, you know, back in ye olden times. Those were our five habitat dinosaurs, we'll call them. Exhibit dinosaurs? No, habitat dinosaurs, but we do have one more. Over here, we have a Microraptor aviary. I've just covered the bottom, nothing much else. And we can actually have 10 dinosaurs in here at once. As you can see, you just click the read Microraptor dinosaur and it adds them straight up into there. Someone is banging very loudly underneath me. So we're gonna head inside, which is super easy to do as well. We can actually track an individual micro, so if we click him, there you go, just hanging out there, poking his head through the holes a little bit, hanging, doing his thing. They are all on, oh, I love that one up there. I've never seen them hang on the sort of the angled roof up there. It's kind of like any aviary you would walk past in a zoo. It's really nice. It feels very much like that and very realistic for an actual zoo. They do move, I promise. This one is just deciding to hate on me because I'm recording for YouTube. But I tell you what, right, I'm going to pick a different one. If you move in a second because I picked a different one, I'm going to be very disappointed in you. You're climbing. That makes you cool. There they go. So they are on a looped animation, but the loops are, at least from what I've seen so far, here we go. The loops are very, very long, so it's very hard to notice unless you just sort of stare. Oh, runs to the ground. Unless you just stare at the Microraptor for a very, very long time. I do think things like this would be very, very difficult to do. Sleeping. It would be very, very difficult to do on a non-looping animation. So that makes a lot of sense. But, yeah, they're pretty cool. Oh, look at them hanging out. Best buddies for life over here. Actually, that one's had a nap, so you're clearly not the most exciting micro-raptor going. Oh, hello. Climbing up in the distance there. You gonna come join us? Oh, there you go. I love them. They're adorable. I mean, side one, that's how much I love them. They are very shiny. I'll give them that much. Anyways, that's it, folks. That is the 6 different dinosaurs of Prehistoric Kingdom. There are also female variants for a lot of these skins. I excluded them because, no offense, any female dinosaurs watching this, but the female skins tend to be a little bit less exciting. You know, men in the Animal Kingdom tend to have the more colourful skin patternings, basically, in order to attract the females in the first place. So, I kind of didn't bother with that, but I love this game already. It is alpha, there are bugs, there's a lack of content, blah, 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 but it's very, very promising so far. I really hope you guys enjoyed this look at the 6 dinosaurs of Prehistoric Kingdom. I will, of course, be bringing you any updates on the game in terms of new dinosaurs and new content being added. And, of course, we are going to build a zoo of our own very, very soon. Hopefully starting tomorrow, we're going to build a nice zoo with all 6 species, but in much more custom-made and fancy-ass habitats, basically. It's been a really good day. I hope all of you playing the game are enjoying it, but if not, you know, stick around with us for the content. There's a playlist down below. Make sure you subscribe. Make sure you hit that like button. I will like your face more than I currently do, which is already a lot, by the way. I'm just saying. I'm in a good mood. Hope you guys are too. Hope you all have a lovely weekend. I'll see you tomorrow for part 1 of our zoo build here in Prehistoric Kingdom. Thanks for joining me. Cheers, much love as always. Bye-bye. Reaching out.